I'm Miss Marley 1995, and you're watching the Hall Monitor on the Hall Vlog channel.
Vroom, vroom.
Thanks for checking out episode 9 of the Hall Monitor. We're just as surprised as you are that we stuck with this crazy show for this long. To celebrate National Aboriginal Day on June 21st, all of the featured gurus in today's show are from that weird, foreign, crazy country, Canada. Or as I'd like to call it, that place where people say about funny.
It's a boot not censoring our art. It's a boot. What's so goddamn funny?
We're also going to find out who won last month's t-shirt contest. But first, let's get things started with a guru I actually plan on saying happy birthday to in person later this month at IMATS LA, Miss Marley 1995. And in her latest favorites video, she gets things started with this product that you put, the thing. I'll just let her describe it.
The strawberry thingamajiggums. It's like a hard lip balm sort of thing. I'll just show it to you. I don't know how to describe it.
Oh boy, looks like she's having just as difficult a time as I had describing it. We're screwed.
It's so great for summer because I love fruity smelling stuff.
Oh my god, I love fruity smelling stuff. Yeah, that didn't come out right.
My mom's not doing it over there. That's so awkward. Awkward turtle.
What?
Awkward turtle. Awkward turtle. Awkward turtle.
Yeah, that's what I thought she said. Still confused. Must be a Canadian thing.
The last product is the Benetint by Benefit, and everyone knows it.
Since everyone knows it, my job is done. Next up, Luba Alana from Nova Scotia. In this haul, she shows us a couple items she picked up from a recent shopping trip down in Maine.
So then I bought this cute little, kind of like a sweater dress type thing. It says something in French.
It says something in French? And you call yourself a Canadian. You don't even know what it says. Shame on you. It's like me being a Californian not knowing what something says in Mexican.
And I also bought this shirt from Forever 21. Just a nice blue. It's kind of... I don't know, it's not lace, it's kind of sheerish. Sheerish? It's kind of sheer. You can kind of see through it, like I can see my camera right through this.
I like playing peekaboo.
And then for t-shirts, because I love t-shirts, I bought this from Hollister, and it says Sunshine Love.
Whew, at least you knew what that shirt said. You know, after that whole French fiasco, I was doubtful.
Oh, I'm putting on lip gloss. Oh, yeah. Oh, girl, what are you putting on your lips?
Oh, it's my EOS lip balm.
Girl, let me see that Easter egg in your hand.
What? Here you go.
Can I put some on?
No way.
Must be a Canadian thing. In this hair tutorial by Miss White 17, she demonstrates how to get curls using a straightening iron, which I find odd. You know, if my grade 9 woodshop teacher taught me anything, it's that in order to do a job right, you gotta have the right tools. And using a straightening iron to get curls, well...
And I thought I'd show you guys how I kind of got these very loose waves using my straightening iron. So I'm actually using my chi to do this.
As a kid, I took karate lessons. Kicked out after the first day. Sensei said I had no chi.
All you need is just a heat protectant, a comb to brush through your hair, and some hairspray. So let's get started, and stay tuned if you'd like to see how I got this look.
Stay tuned? Really? You know this video's on YouTube, right?
And so the first thing I'm gonna do is just split my hair down the middle. I prefer to just do like one side and then the other side.
One side at a time? Come on. Where's the challenge in that? I mean, you wanna impress me, bust out 2 flat irons and go all John Woo on your hair. You know what I'm saying? No? No? John Woo? Director? Hard Boiled? The Killer? Dual Pistols? Never mind.
All I'm going to do is just take sections about this big, and they don't all have to be the same size. It really doesn't matter.
What? It doesn't matter? Seriously?
Yes!
Now it's time to announce last month's t-shirt contest winner. But before I do, I just want to say that not only are subscribers a bunch of liars for saying they'd buy our shirt if we ever put them up for sale, which we did, and nobody bought, but we can't even give our shirts away to you guys. I mean, we had one single entry for this contest from Mommy Lady. That's pathetic. Not only that, but my fake Papua New Guinea example entry was more creative than hers. I mean, I should send the t-shirt to that tribe. They could probably use it more than she does. But I won't. So, congratulations, Mommy Lady, for being the only subscriber that gives a sh. Well, that will do it for a very special Canadian episode of The Hall Monitor. Be sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter. We've also got a voicemail, but much like our t-shirt contest, no one really seems to care about that either. Maybe Mommy Lady will leave us a message. Next month is episode 10, the final episode of the season, which actually means nothing. But much like Miss White 17, we're just as confused about our videos only being on YouTube. But like a real season finale, we'll be sure to leave you guys with a cliffhanger. Like, will there be a season 2? Stay tuned.